In this video, we're going to walk you through creating your first test in Testim. Now, obviously, we're making a few assumptions, namely that you have an account in Testim and you can actually go ahead and log in. Let's go ahead and get started. So here you noticed we've clicked on this editor icon in the top left, and what we're seeing here is Testim's visual editor. This is used for the creation, editing, and debugging of tests. Now, tests in Testim are made up of manually recorded and custom actions that are displayed as tiled steps in the editor view. Now, each step in Testim has different properties, which can control how a step is executed. For example, I can set some basic information, like the URL of the application under test. I can put in the name. I can add a description if I wanted to. I can do some more advanced configurations. And finally, I can also pass in test data, which can be used for more data-driven testing. Let's go ahead and click on record. Now, as you can see here, it says we're recording our test, and as I start interacting with objects on the page, it's creating a test step in the test canvas for me. Let's do a basic login test here, and I'm going to go ahead and click on pause. So as you can see here, we created a basic login test. But let's say I wanted to continue recording and add more steps. I certainly can do that here if I wanted to record more steps. Actually, what I wanted to do is perform a validation. So if I scroll over here to the right, you notice there's this icon called Testim Predefined Steps. If I wanted to click on this, there's a ton of different things you can do here. You can validate that you can download a file, a PDF file, a text file. You can validate that an email has been sent to a certain email address. Maybe you're setting up a registration of a new user for the service. What we're going to pick is validate element text, because we want to validate that we've actually logged into the product and that we see the text "Hello, John" there. And we can see that that's correct. Now let's go ahead and actually click continue on recording. Click log out. We're not going to touch on reusable groups. That's what this auto record your steps is. We're going to ignore that because we're going to go through and create the test manually as we did. And as you can see here, we created a basic test. The other nice thing about this, if all the tiles in the test step, as you can see here, there's an icon in each one of the tiles, which really gives you a sense of what object on the page we're interacting with, which makes understanding what the test is doing much easier. Now, as you can see here, without any background in software development, knowledge of Selenium or other programming tools, we created a fairly complex test. If we were to create this same test with a tool like Selenium, it would take several hours. And as you can see here, we've reduced that time to about a minute. Another thing to point out with the tiles here at the bottom is, if you noticed, let's say we wanted to move some certain steps around, I can do that here. Okay, so you can notice how I move those steps. Or if I wanted to delete certain steps, I could do that here if I wanted to delete a step, which I'm not going to do. Let's go actually and play this test back. And at the very beginning here, once the test starts, we can see that any test step that has passed is green. Any test step that has thrown a warning is yellow. If a step had failed, it would be red, and it would mark the entire test case as failed. So hopefully this provided some nice overview in how to create a test in Testim and how easy it was to do that. Feel free to reach out to us or go out to the website if you have additional questions or information.